With this, we come to the end of the presentations. In the words of Roald Dahl, there are no strangers here, just friends we haven't met. And all of us have surely lived up to this quote, very often ungluing ourselves from our work desks and forging bonds with the interns and mentors here. This internship has given us much more than just technical knowledge and a project. It has given us experiences and memories, leaving indelible impressions on our heart and mind, for which we are grateful.
Fatak sir has always been a great source of inspiration for all of us. We would like to thank him for providing us the internship opportunity and letting us know the work culture of IIT Bombay. His principle of breaking 24 hours into 8 hours each was immensely useful for me. We are highly indebted to all our mentors present here who helped us throughout our internship period.
In the end, I would like to say, goodbyes are not forever. Goodbyes are not the end. They simply mean we'll miss you until we meet again.
So now on this note, we are signing off as
Muskan Srivastav
and Shubhendrapal Singhal, and we would like to call upon Fatak sir for the further proceedings. A huge round of applause for him.
I begin with the observation that we are only 1.5 hours late behind schedule. But I think a reasonably good dinner is waiting for us here. So I would like to wind up quickly. I suggest the process that we follow is I'll first distribute the certificates to each one individually. Then there were some 4 prizes which we had announced for the software quota people. And then if you are still alert and not too much hungry, I may speak for 5 or 7 minutes. Is that okay?
Shivam Patel, development of Sunbird analytics and medium scale deployment of Sunbird. Mr. Harshit Gupta, implementation of content repository for project Sunbird. Mr. Prateek Kayast. Mr. Vishal Gupta.
Mr. Srijan Roy Chaudhary. Mr. Ashutosh Balachandra Sathe. Ms. Pravalika. Nikhil Kumar Yadav. Mayuk Mukherjee. Yash Thakur. Mr. Sutanay Bhattacharji.
Miss Nidhi Dubey. Mr. Pranav Bijwe.
Mr. Adarsh Singh.
Mr. Saurabh Shwetab Singh.
मजा आ गया कोटिंग वोटिंग करिए बढ़िया हमें को बोलना ठीक है मिस्टर धनुष सर मिस्टर नवीन टी
मिस अलेख्या Mr. Siddharth.
Mr. Tanmay Gupta. Mr. Buditi Prasad.
Miss Mudra Sahu.
Your name to lady. Miss Muskan Srivastav. Miss M. Surya. Mr. Abdul Satar Mahapara. Mr. Chaitya. Finally.
Mr. Omkar Prabhu.
Chandraj. Ek minute ruk. Miss Chandranikar. Mr. Utkarsh Shukla.
Miss Shreya. Mr. Vishrut Jaitley.
Mr. Divyansh Sharma. Mr. Rahul Raj.
Miss Samadrita Sarkar.
Rahul. Mr. Shrikant. Mr. Thana, I missed you. Miss Arushi Jain.
Mr. Tanmoy Ghosh.
Miss Aditi Srivastav.
Mr. Prakash Kumar. Mr. Ravi Chandra.
Mr. Badrinath. Mr. Pradeep.
Mr. Jay Modi.
Jay Modi. Mr. Prabhjit Singh Arora. Pallavi Chetia.
Miss Pallavi Chetia. Mr. Bharat Bhushan Reddy. Oh.
Mr. Miss Kanika Dhiman. Miss Kanika Dhiman.
Miss Komal.
Mr. Shrujan Patel. Mr. Durgesh Bharanwal. Bharwal. Mr. Ruchit.
Mr. Aryaman.
Stop, he's second of all. He's second of all. He's second of all. Indranil Biswas. Next one.
Miss Khushbu Shah.
Mr. Pranav Vyas. Mr. Kaushik Sridhar.
Mr. Shubhendra Pal Singhal. Mr. Puneet Agarwal. Mr. Abhishek Datta.
Miss Kanika Srimali. Mr. Aditya Garg. Mr. Aman Gupta. Mr. Anshuman Chaurasia. Mr. Amay. Miraj Ali. Rajat Bhatta.
Miss Shreya.
From OER repository using DSpace for collaborative communities portal.
Thank you, sir.
So when we started admitting people out of some 3,000-4,000 applicants, there's a process of software contest which our erstwhile colleague Avinash Haute had set up. Because as I mentioned, while we do believe that top academic performers would generally be good, we know that there are several people whose performance in terms of grades need not be the highest or best in a college, but they have a lot of creative abilities. And we select a large number of participants from that software quota as well. To incentivize people to put in their best effort, I think some cash prizes were announced. Yes. Since the cash prizes cannot be part of any IIT process administratively, it is handled independently, and I am glad to call these four people in the reverse order who performed the best amongst thousands of participants in that contest. So I am happy to call Ravichandra Kaminanar. Ravichandra is here? Yes. The third prize is won by Aryama. The second prize is won by Rahul Raj. And the top performer was Srikant, dear. Okay, so as I said, I'll try to be very brief as far as possible because I've been advised to eat something soft and go to sleep immediately. I won't sleep here while speaking, don't worry on that. You've been here for almost 7 weeks now, right? That has been a long time. Did you enjoy your stay here? And did you also learn something useful through the internship?
Yes, sir.
Well, these were the main objectives of the entire program. Of course, most of you have contributed something significant, and it will find its way into the open source community over a period of time. We'll start using some of your work immediately. Some other will continue to further enhance. But what I wanted to tell you is, I think I had mentioned it earlier, that the ethos of this place is what makes this institution different. Otherwise, there is absolutely no reason why every college in the country cannot do exactly what we do here. We have not fallen from the sky, although the government has been partial in giving us money. But it's not the money, it's the people who actually make the difference. You have seen your mentors, they are all, most of them project staff doing their full-time work and still they are interested. And I believe this kind of mentoring is an important attribute of our educational process. Why is it that we cannot carry it out in your institutions? So one suggestion I have is, take back from this place not just the sweet memories of both work and enjoyment here, but also of this ethos. Start building mentoring clubs in your places. You are now senior students. There will be lots of youngsters. You recall that day when you entered the precincts of your institute in the first year. You must be shivering. And over a small period of few years, you have now come to a level where you can appreciate things that are happening globally, can participate, can contribute. Why not every student of your college be empowered to do the same thing, at least to attempt this? Now, this cannot happen automatically. You see, the colleges have set processes. IIT, NIT system at least have reasonable autonomy to implement things the way they wish to. But other colleges do not necessarily have that. But can you not exercise the autonomy of a learner and extend it to the autonomy of a group of learners? That is what I would like to suggest. That don't let the learnings from this place rest in your minds alone. Try to spread it. That is what is required. Remember, as I mentioned, that at least 30 crore Indian children who wish to learn in schools, forget the colleges, they don't even know how many of them will be able to see the face of a college. And the national responsibility is to try and give to as many of them opportunities for learning and opportunities later on for livelihood. And who will create those opportunities? Obviously, the luckier ones like you, the better prepared like you, and the better performers like you. So you have to perform extraordinarily well in life, not only for yourselves and your families, but for the rest of the society, because they look forward to it. Believe me when I say this, that each one of you is capable of contributing non-linearly to the wealth and ethos of this nation. Non-linearly is the key word. Every one of us will probably do some job, earn some money, whatever, whatever. But the impact that you make on others can be non-linear because you have it in you, you have proven it. You have proven it by getting admission to the well-deserved institutions, your own subject of studies, etc. All of you will get good jobs, some of you will study further. But don't forget this, that the impact-making power that you possess is non-linear. Please exploit it. Give that power a way out, 1 hour a week, 2 hours a week, whatever. Decide to do something, but do it consistently. Believe me, you can make amazing difference. And spread this word further. There is no reason why such efforts cannot be done in every institution. You can have local groups doing this work and so on. Last thing I would like to tell you is that the world is not just technology and technical solutions. It's not just academics as we understand it. Life is way beyond that. When you live here, you know, many of you mentioned that one of the learnings was teamwork. Why should teamwork only be limited to the team activities that are forced upon you, as in this internship or in some events that you organize? Why can't we inculcate the notion of working in teams across the society? Lastly, when you lead your professional lives, I think all of you have at least one or two more years in the college, right? But when you pass out, you will get jobs, whatever, and then you will settle. And when you settle down, what will you look for? Opportunities in your own stream of specialization or profession. You would like to get promoted, like to build yourself into a top position. But essentially, what all of us are seeking as human beings is happiness. Mostly we believe that happiness will come if we earn a lot of wealth. Partly true, but not fully true. But have you ever wondered that making other people happy could give you far more happiness? And making other people happy is not only in terms of your behavior with the individuals with whom you work, your colleagues, your family members, but others. Be sensitive to the society, and in order to be recognized as somebody useful, you'll have to go way beyond your successes in academic front. I mean, you pass with a degree, you get a degree from a good college, you get a job, you are recognized, of course. But your recognition should come from a stature that you should build as a human being. And that is not very easy. Remember, I mentioned the temptation in which a teacher actually copied assignment submitted by someone, changed the name and submitted that assignment. The temptation got caught. What if the person was not caught? What if the person actually got qualification marks because of that stolen assignment? How many times it has happened with us, with our friends? Do we learn from these mistakes? Do we recognize these as mistakes and woe not to repeat them? Such are the things which build your stature. You'll be dealing with lots of money, not only your own, but your companies, your organizations. Even now when you organize events in your colleges, there is a lot of money there. When you handle money, do you handle it with the same respect with which you will handle your own money? With the same care with which you handle your own money? These are fiduciary responsibilities. And temptations would be great if you are handling somebody else's money. To avoid those temptations and do that well is a characteristics which the academics doesn't teach us. It has to be learned firsthand from life. Okay. I always tell people that Indians lack in prolific use of three words. You know what those three words are? Please, thank you, and sorry. We have flowery languages and so on, but whenever we request someone, we rarely say please. Are wo kitab de de. Please kitab de nahi niklega. Usne kitab di, thank you nahi niklega. Haan. Does it mean that we are insensitive to people? Not at all. We are actually very sensitive. We love our friends, we love our families, we love even other people. We want to help. If in case there is somebody who requires help, we do go out of the way to help. But we don't show our love with the correct articulation. Okay. If we make a mistake, to say sorry is the biggest hurdle because our ego comes in between. We have to first admit that we made a mistake. And secondly, we have to admit openly that we made a mistake. Not easy at all. Just go back and reflect how many times you have said please to someone, how many times you have said thank you to someone, and how many times you have said sorry to someone. I would seriously suggest that if you contemplate and adopt some of these things, believe me, your life will be happier. What you all seek in life eventually is happiness. Yeah, happiness comes through multiple means. It's not just one thing which will make you happy. But make sure that you don't let any human being alone and away, because that human being is what connects to you as another human being, and that is what makes the world, and make the world as happy as you want yourself to be. Believe me, when you spread happiness, your happiness will return back to you as well. You'll enjoy. So enjoy life, work hard, and dream big, really, really big. Not only for yourself, but for the entire society, for the entire country. Why IIT Bombay does these things is because India, Indian Institute of Technology Bombay, India as a nation has spent hell of a lot of money to create this institution and the ethos. And this money comes from where? From the people of India. Most of your institutions do have money from people of India. All your parents who have earned, who actually have empowered you to pay the fees and join and so on, that money has also come from the society. So never forget that we owe a lot, not necessarily directly, but huge amount indirectly to the entire society. And particularly those in the society who are as good as you, but not as fortunate as you, I think they deserve not to be helped when they ask you for help. But they deserve to be located, found, approached, and helped. And that is what I think will provide you an opportunity to make completely significant and non-linear impact on the society. These 120 people assembled here are special. Don't ever forget that. Each one of you is special. And you cannot do just ordinary things in life. You have to do something special. Do it for yourself, do it for your family, but do it for the society. Thank you so much. All the best.